How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today I'm going to show you guys how you can unblock stake if you are in the United States. As you can tell here, it will not be available to you. So what we're looking for here are VPNs that are reliable enough to unblock such geo-restrictions. We need to trick the website here to think that we are elsewhere, such as Canada or Brazil, where stake is fully available. So before beginning, if you guys are interested in any of the VPNs mentioned today, be it Express, Nord, or Surfshark, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below, as well as full reviews if you'd like to learn more about these VPNs. So I'm going to go ahead and disconnect from the US server. I'm not in these states, which is why I connected to the NordVPN state server here in order to kind of show you guys how this works. So what we're going to need to do here is look for either a Canadian server or a Brazilian server. In all of these VPNs have such servers. So we've got Canada, Brazil, same with Express. If we just go to, we'll go ahead and just look them up. So we've got Brazil here. We've got a couple of locations in Brazil. And with Canada, I believe we have about four locations. There we go. So four locations. It's very simple. Okay, so yeah, let's just go ahead and connect to a Canadian server actually and see what happens. So Canada, I'll let ExpressVPN pick one for me, and let's just go ahead and connect and see what happens. Now, for some websites, you might have to remove the part of the URL that restricts you, that just shows that it's restricted, but we might not have to do this in this case. I know I have to do that with HBO, for example, when I'm trying to unblock HBO Max, but let's see what happens here. I didn't have to do that. Okay, so it is fully available in Canada and in Brazil, and apparently it's coming to the UK. And by the way, even if you're in a country where stake is available, besides Canada or Brazil, for example, I would still recommend that you use a VPN to hide your real IP address, because you know, another concern when gambling online is security. Coincidentally, hackers love websites where there's actual money waiting to be stolen from users. A VPN enhances your privacy by hiding your real IP address and encrypting your whole traffic with a virtually unbreakable cipher. What's more, a zero locks policy, which is a standard for all top VPNs. A zero locks policy will ensure that a VPN server has no data about you. So breaking into one of them is also futile. So, these VPNs also being run on RAM servers means that there are no physical drives to store your data in. And putting casinos and betting aside, a good VPN will help against other types of geo-blocking. This includes Netflix and other streaming platforms, media outlets, and more. Additionally, you'll be able to torrent safely knowing that neither your internet service provider nor your government can snoop on your traffic. So these three VPNs, I know earlier I mentioned that stake is available in Brazil. I think I was wrong there. I believe it's Mexico. So either way, there are Brazilian, Mexican, Canadian, whatever servers you're looking for on all these three VPNs. And if you're looking for the biggest variety, you've got over 3,000 servers in 94 countries. So that's plenty of countries for you to kind of test out whatever server you're looking for in whatever region. No matter where you're living, you'll definitely find a country or server nearby with ExpressVPN. And you've got basic features such as the kill switch called network lock here, which will stop your internet traffic if the VPN disconnects unexpectedly. This will make sure that none of your data leaks out of the VPN tunnel in case the VPN disconnects unexpectedly. Split tunneling will let you choose which applications are routed through the VPN and which are not. So this can be useful if you just want to use the VPN on a single application or vice versa. So it can be very useful for a lot of people. You have a handful of protocols, just use the best performing protocol, which will be the lightweight UDP in this case. It works 99% of the time, at least for me, and that's pretty much it. ExpressVPN will allow you to secure up to 5 devices per subscription. Now, using Netflix as a reference, ExpressVPN will allow you to unblock up to 18 Netflix libraries 10 with Nord, and 15 libraries with Surfshark. So great stuff overall with these VPNs when it comes to unblocking streaming services. Obviously, keep in mind that specifically Netflix US and other Netflix libraries, if you happen to not be able to unblock a specific Netflix library, make sure to contact live chat support or just try other servers. I think the best way you can go about this, since Netflix is constantly cracking down on VPN traffic, so it's really it's an inevitable cat and mouse game between streaming services and VPN providers. So you have to kind of sometimes some servers may not work with specific libraries or streaming services. So what you can do is just go to, let's say, ExpressVPN or Nord or Surfshark or whatever, and just hover over the bottom right and ask them which servers work best with whatever streaming service you're trying to unblock, okay? And this is how you can just kind of stay up to date with the best servers that are dedicated for streaming services. For example, with ExpressVPN, Atlanta, LA3, and Miami 2 work well for me. It may have changed, but I usually just use Atlanta. And if it doesn't work, I'll use LA3. And if that doesn't work, I'll just use Miami 2. And if none of them work, I'll just go to the live chat support and ask them what are the best servers to unblock Netflix US. And it's the same with NordVPN here. Now, earlier today, I used the New York server to unblock Netflix US and it worked just fine. But when I talked to the NordVPN live chat support, they did recommend about 10 servers that work just fine with Netflix US. And United States 9505 is one of them. So I was able to use this one to unblock Netflix US. Now, besides streaming, you've got over 5,100 servers in 60 countries with NordVPN, and you'll be able to secure, again, 6 devices, one more than ExpressVPN's 5. You've got specialty servers. You've got the ad blocker right here. And if you switch to OpenVPN, you will be able to have access to 2 more servers, 2 more specialty server lists here. Onion over VPN is usually there, but sometimes it goes under maintenance, so they take it away for a little bit. Stick to NordVPN for the best performance, though. You have the internet kill switch, the conventional internet kill switch, as well as an app kill switch, which will close selected apps when you disconnect from the VPN or the connection drops. Split tunneling, just like ExpressVPN. Custom DNS is an easy way to change your DNS. If you want a DNS, perhaps that is faster or provides you better security or whatever it is, whatever the reason may be, obfuscated servers are for those living in censorship-heavy countries. With Surfshark, you've got over 3,200 servers in 65 countries, and you'll be able to unblock virtually an unlimited number of devices with Surfshark. Now, Surfshark being such a budget-friendly VPN does not mean that you'll be sacrificing much on security, performance, or features for that matter. You still get specialty servers such as double VPN, which is called multi-hop here, or static IP. Double VPN or multi-hop routes your connection to 2 servers rather than 1 for extra security. And static IP is just self-explanatory. It'll give you the static same IP every time you go to these servers, one of these servers. Split tunneling is called whitelister here. Kill switch, the ad blocker, and you've got a handful of protocols, including the Shadow Sox protocol, which will help you reach banned websites if you're in a censorship-heavy country. Though WireGuard usually does just fine when combined with No Borders mode. So No Borders mode will help you bypass internet restrictions such as the Great Firewall of China. So I hope you guys learned something. This is how you can unblock Stake and play it in the US or wherever you are, really doesn't matter. You can just simulate a location and you'll be able to access it reliably as if you're in that location using a VPN. Now, all these VPNs are covered by a 30-day money-back guarantee. So if you just go ahead and get started, let's say with ExpressVPN, and it's the same with Nord and Surfshark. They're all covered by a 30-day money-back guarantee. And if anything happens, you can still hover over the bottom right and get access to the live chat support, where you'll be able to ask for a refund or any other question you might be having about any of these VPNs. And obviously, it's the same with Nord and Surfshark. So that'll be it for this video. Remember, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below, as well as full reviews if you'd like to learn more about these VPNs in terms of their privacy policy, speed streaming and torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. Besides that, comment below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. Thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.